Welcome to Adecco TV. I'm Ann Meyer. You're joining us from Sherm's 2011 annual conference and exposition in Las Vegas, Nevada. Here, we're bringing you the latest trends and innovative solutions from some of the country's leading experts in the HR industry. Joining me now is Christine Zebrowski, the owner of Overbrook Law. Thanks so much for joining us.
Good morning.
How can HR professionals best assess EEOC claims, and what is an effective strategy to do that?
The first thing the HR professional needs to do is investigate. Start with the file, pull the employee file together, a personnel file, the manager file, anything you can easily pull together to get a sense of what the claim is about. After you review the documents, then you can identify the key witnesses, because you're going to need to speak to the employee is still there at the company, and the manager, and whoever else may be named in the complaint. Sometimes there's an accused person, if it's a harassment claim or a discrimination claim. There may be coworkers who are named as witnesses. You sort of gather everyone together, circle the wagon. You have to be very clear that everything must be maintained confidentially. Okay? And that preserves the integrity of your investigation, and it also helps protect against retaliation against the employee or any witnesses who would be interviewed, and that's very, very important. Once you get into the investigation, you can determine whether the documents and the witnesses are telling the same story. You need to determine whether your policies and practices have been followed. On every charge, there's a name of someone at the EEOC to contact. Developing a relationship to the extent you can with the investigator helps a lot. You always want to be civil and polite to the investigator. You want them to believe that your company is a good guy, that you're a reasonable employer, that you want to do the right thing. Make sure you read the documents thoroughly. If you get a stack of documents like this out of a personnel file, it's very tempting just to thumb through them. Read them. Pull out the ones that really matter. Sometimes there are only 10 or 12 documents that really pertain to the case, and that's going to give you the information that you need to go from. And the more concrete the claim becomes, the resolution is more focused. Avoiding litigation is very important, and mediation is one of the ways that you can do it. Mediation gives the employer an opportunity to hear what the employee has to say. Hearing the employee sometimes helps diffuse the situation, and it gives the employer a chance to explain what happened, because so many times employment claims arise out of misunderstandings. And by having the parties come to the table and talk together, you can clear things up and avoid litigation. Another thing you want to think about is, what jurisdiction are you in? Are you in California, where it's very pro-employee? Are you in Florida, where it might be more pro-employer? What's the risk in court if, you know, it goes forward? You have to take those things into account as well.
Thanks so much, Christine. Of course, for more information from Sherm 2011 and to keep your finger on the pulse of cutting-edge trends and insights from the HR industry, visit us at clearingthepicture.com and adeccousa.com. Thanks for joining us at Adecco TV.